I am just going to start because we can. This is going to be recorded, so I think like we are going to be putting this online. So I there are some slides that I have to go through, even though maybe I almost know most of you here already. But I think it is worth it. So this talk is going to be about how to create a human culture in a software company. So, and we are just starting. I am Patti. My real name is Bjarni Sonja Ólafsdóttir. I'm married to Christoph, who is also here in the chat. So therefore, I adopted his last name. I'm Icelandic. I live in Frankfurt, Germany. I have a bachelor's degree in computer science, and I've just been working in the computer industry for now almost 20 years. And I'm the owner and co-founder of 1X Internet. Also, just before we were in the Drupal Association, I'm there in the board. There was a talk earlier this day, and you can find me on Twitter, and please feel free to tweet me something nice there. I told you about the company 1X Internet. So we are a full service digital agency in Europe, and we do most of our solutions based on Drupal, using Drupal and React and Next.js. And we do the full cycle. But that's not what I'm going to be talking about today. I am more going to go in the direction of like our company is divided and we are very international. So we have offices in Reykjavik, Spain, Frankfurt, and Berlin. But we also have people sitting in those cities that we see here and plus other ones that I haven't like made to add yet. But there is Truls sitting in Oslo and Dennis in Ukraine. So we speak over 18 different languages, and we come from a lot of different places in the world. So that goes into the direction of these are just the places where we are sitting at the moment, but we come from other places. Like for example, Stefan, our CTO, he comes from Chile. I have a lot of slides to talk about, so therefore I'm going to go a bit quick through this, and I hope to have a good conversation with you here in the chat. I am listening and I'm watching the chat, so feel free if you want to write me something there. First of all, I want to talk about the fact that software is complex and software is made by humans, and that means that this is not just a company where we can have like very simple rules and we just should follow them. It's actually we are building complex things, and we are all humans. So therefore, this is important to just keep in mind when we are running a software company. And to tell you a little bit about like who are the people who are working in our company. Here you see Majid. Majid is from Pakistan, and he is here in the office in Frankfurt. And like you see on the right side, he brings sometimes food over and to allow us to, learn about his culture in the company of those who are here in Frankfurt. Here we have Truls and Fran. Truls is in Norway. And as an example here, they are working here together, and Truls is deaf and uses sign language and interpreters. And it's extremely nice to see like how easy it is also to communicate through online tools, because tools are getting so much better. But on top of that, just to be able to be very active and interactive in an online environment is just really nice to see in our company. Here we have Sveta and Artem. They are also here since a couple of years. They're also here in Frankfurt. They come originally both from Ukraine. And Sveta was before she studied engineering, and then she moved over to the software part and is now one of our front-end developers. And Artem is in more focused on the back end. Here are the guys from the south, like I like to call them. So Joao and Pablo and Fran and Mauricio coming from south. So they're here all in and of course, like if you know the people from the south, it's amazing to go down there to Spain because, lunch is of course at a different time, and then we have lunch in Germany because in Germany we have lunch at 12:30, and in Spain the lunch happens much more later, and it's just a little bit different type of a culture. So showing that we have a very many different people in our company, but we all have everything in common. We are trying to create great software here. These are the newest members. Hossein came from Iran, or he is originally from there, but he lived somewhere else. And Albert is from Dominican Republic. So like you see, we speak a lot of languages. We are from very many different places of the world, and we are very many family people as well in the company. Here are our kids, and we bring them to Drupal events as well. So this is just a little bit of an introduction into the part of that. This is who we are, and we are all humans working together to create software. So that's not just what we do. You know, so when we do the software, it's not like that we just do Drupal. You know, if we actually look at it, you know, here's just an example of all the tools and all the software and libraries and everything that we're using. And if anybody knows what the green thing is there, write it in the chat. I'm curious to see who knows what that is. The green thing there on the corner. But Twig, yes, Walter, correct. Here I just wanted to show like that creating software today is not just knowing one technology. Maybe 20 years ago or 15 years ago, it was enough to know PHP to be able to do something. But today, like, you have to learn all the stack and you have to know so many different things. So it is not just a simple thing to create, it's actually a complex thing. So let's then start by looking at it. So who is actually involved in a software project? Well, if we just put in a couple of roles in here, you have the UX design, account manager, developer. So often there's a couple of developers. There's the product manager, there's the client, there's the solution architect, there's all type of different roles working in a project. But I would like to ask like a question here to all of you. So, but who's the boss? Like, who is in charge? Who in this group is actually in charge? And that is something that I've seen often in my previous experience in working in a software company is like, sometimes there is just a boss over a team like this, but how we look at it, we actually look at roles instead of a hierarchy. And meaning, and there's a lot of text here, I'm sorry for that, I'm not gonna go into the text, but meaning is like, every single role that we watched earlier is something that like that you are supposed to deliver within the team. So there is an account manager who understands the business needs. There is definitely at least 2 backend and 2 frontend developers in every team that just make sure that there's always 4 eyes on, you know, 4 eyes principle and everything that needs to be done doing. There is a product manager, and the product manager is like a little bit between and is helping to understand also the client and make sure that things are happening, you know, on the right time and delivered on time. So what we have seen until now, and I hope that all of you also agree with this, is that yes, software creation is complex. Software is created by humans, and software is actually very often created by very smart people. So people are, so we are dealing with a group of very, very clever people, and humans are very different. So how do we create a culture in a company with all of this in front of us? And please, if you have good ideas, make sure you put it into the chat. So one of the first things that we want to focus on is like people want to have success. So people thrive, independent people like me, thrive for some kind of a success. We want to have success in life. Very many of us have been through education or we've been working for a long time and we're doing great things and we just want to have a success. And success can mean very different things between people. So for one, it is successful to be healthy and be able to have a work-life balance, while for somebody else, it is important to, you know, have more responsibility in a team. So people also want to learn and get better. So if you believe that people are motivated by success, you know, then you know that they actually want to become better every time. So you have to make sure that you also give them that platform. So the worst thing that can happen to people in that want to have success and want to learn and get better is to waste their time. So to have unneeded meetings, to have very complex tooling that like nobody understands how to work with the tool, to like send out emails back and forth and have stuff very unorganized. This is for people who are thriving for success and become wanting to become better. This is just for them considering to being a waste of time, and they will not be able to thrive and be able to be successful in an environment like that. So therefore, for example, in our company, we try to make sure that we optimize the meetings as much as we can, because it is important in times like this that we meet. But at the same time, we always try to look at that, you know, that we don't have too many people together and that there's an agenda if we have a focus meeting and so on. And people want to have great colleagues, and they want to be with great colleagues, because if you are doing something complicated, and if you are doing something that is what I talked about earlier, it is complex, then it is just much easier to work on it if you have a good colleague with you. So if you're, I don't know about you, I know that if when I am doing something alone, like this presentation here, doing it alone is much more difficult for me than actually doing it together with somebody else and asking another person for feedback. So Christoph, in this case, helped me to put together here a couple of things, and we talked about it back and forth. And then this task about creating this session for today became much more easier for me because I had a great colleague that could help me. So that is just like one of the things. So we look at that, we talked about it earlier, that we are doing complex things and we are humans and we are very different. But we definitely have something in common, I think, that we want to have success and we want to learn and get better. And we want to have good colleagues around us. So what else do we want to do? So what we have realized very, you know, well is that people want to meet others and they want to work in environments that are friendly. So we spend almost as much time at work with our colleagues as we do with our family. Because or friends, because the rest of the 8 hours we hopefully sleep. So therefore, it's extremely important to make sure that when you come to work, that it is actually fun. That it doesn't have to be fun of like, you know, there are balls all everywhere and like, you know, having that type of fun that you can play football all the time. It just needs to be nice. It needs to be a place where you like to go and where you actually like you enjoy spending your time. So that is a little bit the status, and this is a little bit that we need to focus on all the time at our company, of how we can actually make sure that our people thrive and become better and so on. And that is probably the key to understanding that coming myself from being a developer for almost 10 years or 8 years, you know, I didn't like when other people were just telling me what to do and so on. You know, I'm smart, or I consider myself to be smart, at least in a way of when I was doing this. And I wanted to have an opinion and I wanted to be listened to. And I respected that other people had more experience and I wanted to listen to them. I wanted to learn from them and I wanted to be treated well. So the main focus is, of course, to make sure that you continue doing this in the company that you are working in or where you're leading. So I want to go. So it's unfortunately a very short talk today. So it's only 30 minutes. So therefore, I'm going really fast. And please leave a question here or feel free to chat with me afterwards, because I really want to go deeper into this. So what is our recipe? So what is the things looking at that? These are the facts that we talked about earlier. So how do we actually then make sure that this happens in the company? One of the things is like, we want to make sure that there is the same team structure for all projects, meaning we talked about it earlier. We try to have at least 2 back-end developers, 2 front-end developers. There is an account manager. There's a product manager. There's a solution architect. There's a UX designer. There's a DevOps person. Everywhere you go, and if you switch projects, it's always the same structure. We always try to make developers and others in the company change teams frequently, because you do not want to be maybe on a project for more than 6 to 12 months, because at some point you just get enough. You need to see something else. You can't just be writing the same book again and again. At some point, you need to do something else to be able to become effective again. So that we try to focus on, and of course, like mixing teams. So it's not that we just take the same team and we let them then do the next project and the next project. We actually try to mix so they learn from each other as well. Then we think a lot about like how can we foster the friendship and these colleagues gathering of people. So we have, for example, in Frankfurt, we try to go, you know, to the Indian buffet regularly that we really like. There is here next door. We try to do game nights, grilling. We in Spain, we try to do the same thing. We try to go together and in our office in Berlin as well. And we also want to enable that our employees can actually go to these places whenever they want. So, for example, now in September, our colleagues from Berlin, they could travel over to Frankfurt. And Lolo, who is in Romania, he actually also came over to Frankfurt. And that was extremely important because meeting in person is just different from hanging out on the internet in videos because the relationship just becomes different. So we also do all of these organized company meetings. So twice per week, we all meet. So we meet all on Monday mornings and just say hi to each other and just go a little bit quickly through what is happening in the week. And the same thing we happen on Thursday, where we give an update of new projects and what is going on. And so everybody can be involved and knowing what the others are doing and not just what they are doing themselves. I spoke a little bit about this before when I showed you the group of what we have in our company, so that we have roles. And the collaboration goes beyond the hierarchy because we believe that hierarchy blocks efficiency and that collaboration is actually much more effective. So there is a little quote there, like we are working on complex software with different people that are motivated by success and are eager to learn new things. And that means that like we believe in that working together is better than being somebody like me now saying, you do this, you do that, and then I just leave. So if I am part of this, I am actually then also having a role within that project and I am working and doing my part of it instead of just telling somebody else how they should do it. This is extremely important in our company. And of course, when new people come in, we need to teach and show others like that this is just better because often people come from companies where there's very strong hierarchies. So it can be a little bit confusing coming into a company where there's little hierarchy, but still functional teams because of the collaboration. So that goes to the point, by having a role, you can have a responsibility. So we are encouraging our people to take responsibility and helping the team to find the best solutions within the range that they have. So of course, learning and mentoring others. And I think like, we have a very strong mechanism of allowing people to contribute, especially to Drupal in this case, just in generally to learn and to become better. And we thrive to like look at new technologies to see if they are something that we should go into. And then we give people also time to learn. And we make sure when we mix people in teams that they also then get like an example of maybe somebody has never worked on a commerce project before, then yes, we put that person on the commerce project with somebody who is really good in doing commerce projects, because then that person is going to learn from the other person and then they become better. And next time, maybe they can take more responsibility in that project. So what is just above everything is just, of course, just be friendly and professional. So in a company, you know, that needs to just be always repeated, not because people are not, but I think it is just like always important because we are writing stuff on Slack all the time, And we speak different languages. We come from different cultures. We have different way of how we translate things into another language. So it is all about just being friendly, being professional. It's about like respecting the other person that you're working with. So one of our motivation, or like one of our things that we always repeat in all of our retreats that we do, is this: be the best you can be. And looking at everything that we talked about before, you know, then you are going to be a better person and you're going to be happy. And in our case, and how you should look at it if you are leading a company, is that let everyone be the best they can be. So look at the good things that people have. And if you're giving them opportunities to work on something and you see and you notice that that is too big for them, make sure that you see it, that you can, you know, make sure that the person gets help so they can actually become the best version of themselves of doing that, because that is extremely important, because otherwise they will become unhappy. And I think you know, giving people opportunity to work purposely and find meaning in their work should be a universal goal for all kinds of businesses. And when I put out this talk and I was promoting that, or I was just like sending it to my network, then one of my network, Fia, she wrote this to me and she said, it's really interesting that you're talking about it from a software company perspective. But I think like all businesses should just have a goal of making sure that people find meaning in their work and that they are happy of what they're doing, that they are trying to become better, and that they also have the place to do that. And that is our role, to actually make them be able to succeed. And that is only possible if you sit and you listen and you watch and you collaborate with everyone. And I think like there are some things that I wanted to go deeper into, and I would be really happy if you have a question here. If not, you can always ping me on Buddy Sonia on Twitter or LinkedIn, or just here in the event. But I'm really curious to hear if you agree, you know, or if you, is there anything that you have experienced in your company that has been good? And it would be really nice to see that here in the chat, if you're willing to share that. You know, I see some of you, I know some of you, you know, that what is it that you think that works the best for people to just be happy and continue working for you? And, you know, do you have any tips for us? Let me know. So we have 5 minutes until it's going to be cut out. Is any questions? It's so silent to be here alone, right? You can also come on stage and say hi. You know, I think I can give access to that. So if not, then I'm just extremely happy here that you came. And I really hope that we can continue this conversation. So let me know if there is any questions that you have. Thank you, Eric. So, thank you, Jasper and Elizabeth. I think if there's anything you want to share with us, that would be really nice. I think we are always reading good books, and I think Krista was actually reading a book about like how Netflix do stuff, and Netflix is of course doing also great things, but they always just try to hire the best people. So they try to like, you know, hire the best, and then if you're not good, then you're just fired. And I think that like that's probably the biggest thing that you know, I think that we disagree with that, because I think like you have to give people opportunity to grow, and you have to mix teams, and you have to be able to have like also people who know less and can learn from others. So that's also an interesting, if you have books or anything, share them here. And otherwise, thank you, Drupal Jam. And if you haven't already registered for DrupalCon Europe happening in the beginning of December, and I'm hoping to see you there. So have a nice day. I'm just going to leave now and go over to the next session that starts at 3. Yeah, so Eric is saying, I prefer people who are willing to learn over the best in their fields. Yeah, I think like that's what we love, when people show that they want to learn and they want to become better. So have a nice day. See you in networking sessions or at some of the booths. Bye.